Welcome to our video tutorials for our PC tool, openSYDE. In this video, we would like to introduce you to the topic of service projects. If you are not yet familiar with the basics of openSYDE, we recommend the video Basic Introduction to openSYDE from this series. openSYDE is primarily used by developers to support application development. In the V model of the development process, we are therefore in the area of implementation. After all requirements for the application have been described, the development environments come into play in the implementation phase, such as LogiCAD for programming in C and IEC 61131, or MATLAB or codebooks, which are supplied by STW. On this level, many functions of openSYDE can also be used. Pure development activities, which are performed in the system definition section in openSYDE, are mainly the description of the topology of a system and later, during the programming of the applications, the creation of data pools and the generation of code. In order to flash the finished applications or EEPROM values to the system's controllers, or, for example, to monitor data pool values during operation, developers apply functions from system commissioning in openSYDE. However, exactly these functions would also be very useful for personnel in field service, so these personnel could also use openSYDE. Perhaps service personnel only need a very few functions of an otherwise complex openSYDE project and should therefore not be able to modify the project. There could also be measurement and setup procedures that are precisely tailored to the tasks of service personnel through dashboards in openSYDE, thus not unnecessarily burdening this user group with development typical functions. Therefore, openSYDE offers the possibility to create a project that is reduced to specific tasks in the system commission area, a so-called service project. In this project, we will not create a new openSYDE project to introduce the service projects. Rather, we will convert an existing project into a service project. STW also provides, in the target support package for each controller, a sample project for using openSYDE in conjunction with the controller. For this video, we use the example project of the ESX4CSGW. I have prepared a directory on this PC. In this directory, I have already installed the target support package that I have previously downloaded from the cloud. In it is the sample project that I will now start. We see a topology in which the controller is connected to all communication interfaces and a third-party device. In the system commissioning area, we can see three views with the functions for configuring the views and for updating the system, i.e. flashing the controller. openSYDE can access the controller via CAN or Ethernet depending on the view. In this example, openSYDE is connected to the system via CAN in view number 1 and number 3. And via Ethernet in view number 2. In each view, different dashboards for input and output configuration or visualization are offered. We will now provide selected functions of system commissioning in a service project with limited access rights. For this, we change to the start page of openSYDE. Here we find the function Create a Service Project. The views are displayed in a dialog. We can configure the access to single subfunctions for the service project. In this example, we do not want to make view number 1 available at all. We want to make view number 2 completely available. This means that configurations and flashing will be possible in the service project, as well as the use of the dashboard via Ethernet. In view number 3, we only want to allow the use of the dashboards via the CAN interface. We create the service project, openSYDE now points out the importance of the password. Only with a password will the service project be encrypted, but this encryption is only a security of the project on the PC side and not a security feature for the whole system, consisting of openSYDE control and communication. You can find more details in the help section. So we assign a password and secure the service project. It is stored under the same path and name as the complete openSYDE project and can be recognized by the file extension syde_sp. This file can now be made available to the service personnel. For demonstration purposes, I move it into a temporary directory. On the PC of the service personnel, only openSYDE must be installed and operational communication interfaces, like for example Ethernet or CAN adapter, must be available. Otherwise, the service project is sufficient. We now slip into the role of the service personnel and open the service project. If the file extension syde_sp is linked with openSYDE, we could start with a double click on the project. After entering the password, the project starts in service mode, which is also signaled to us in the header line. The limited access becomes already clear by grayed out functions. For example, the entire system definition is not available. In system commissioning, we see that there is no access to view number 1. In view number 2, we had all functions unlocked. For the setup function, this means that device configuration would be possible. However, the possibility to change the configuration within this view, e.g. to select another interface for the openSYDE client, is disabled. In the update function, full access is granted. However, openSYDE indicates that it cannot find the hex files for flashing. We have not provided these to the service personnel yet. We do this now in the same structure as in the original project. Now the hex files are also to be found in openSYDE. We could also provide the hex files separately, and the service personnel could load the files manually from a directory of their choice using the select file functions, because this access right is granted by the project. In the same way, additional NVM parameters could be provided under other files, which are then written directly to the EEPROM during the update. So we can update our system. The dashboards in this view are also fully functional in the service project. We can go online and, for example, change this PMW output OPH4A_01 and measure the result with the input IDA35V_01, which I connected in the hardware to the output at our controller for demonstration purposes. In view number 3, we have now, as expected, no access to the function setup and update. So device configuration or flashing is not possible via the CAN interface in this case. However, the dashboards are fully available as in view number 2, in this case the visualization of the CAN messages. We summarize. As the owner of the full openSYDE project, we can create service projects with restricted access rights, for example for service personnel. Service personnel can only use functions of system commissioning. For the service project, it can be defined which view should be usable in whole or in parts for the service personnel. In the series of openSYDE videos, other videos appear on this channel that deal with the details of single features. I wish you every success using openSYDE.